This video is an introduction to our clone series, and you don't need to code along here. If you're watching this video in our app, you can pinch to make it bigger.
Have you ever wondered how to make games that contain lots of objects with engaging and dynamic behaviors? Games that have hordes of enemies which you can fight, that have many non-playable characters that you can interact with, or a rich world environment with lots of plants and animals? In this video series, we'll take a look at how to use clones. Clones allow you to scale code quickly, especially when you're working with lots of objects that have similar behaviors, such as enemies, projectiles, or characters. The idea of scaling means that you can write code for one case or for one object and have it apply to many other objects or contexts with minimal extra work. This is more efficient than writing code manually for each new object or context. We'll be making our own version of Space Invaders in Hopscotch to explore how to use clones. You'll learn how to take advantage of the capabilities that Hopscotch offers with clones, from creating and destroying clones, to working with the clone index and total clones variables. This will enable you to create games which have systems that can scale well, and you'll learn concepts that will let you customize clone behaviors however you like.
We have 4 videos in this series.
They are broken up into parts, so if you want to go over how to use a particular clone functionality, you can easily jump to the relevant video. This first video is the introduction, containing an overview of the series. The second video is an optional recap of the base project that we have provided for you. We will look at the basic mechanics of Space Invaders and touch on how they have been coded. If you would like to get started with using clones, feel free to jump to the third video. In the third video, we will learn the basics of how to create clones in order to add lots of enemies for a more challenging and engaging experience.
The last video is where we look at how to use a destroy block to let you shoot more projectiles at once.
And that's it for this introduction. See you in the upcoming videos, and happy hopscotching!